Let's see some examples how to draw the Nyquist plot. So let's see the first example. Draw the Nyquist plot for the system with transfer function g of s into h of s is equals to 1 by 1 plus s. So if you see it, so it is a type 0 system. So we'll draw the Nyquist plot using the both the methods. So method 1, so let's solve it using method 1. Method 1 means, so Nyquist plot between real part and between imaginary and real. So first replace s with j omega, s equal to j omega. Therefore g of j omega, h of j omega is equals to 1 by 1 plus j omega. Now rationalize it to make it to separate real and imaginary parts. So which will be 1 minus j omega by 1 plus omega square. Therefore real of j omega, h of j omega is equals to 1 by 1 plus omega square. Imaginary of j omega, h of j omega is equals to minus omega by 1 plus omega square. So now take various values of omega and find real and imaginary. Suppose omega equal to 0. If omega is 0, 1 by 1 plus 0 is 1. If omega is 0, so imaginary part will be 0. So let's omega equal to 1. 1 by 1 plus 1 square. So it is equal to 1 by 2. So it is also minus 1 by 1 plus 1, minus 1 by 2. Say take omega equal to 10. 1 by 1 plus 10 square, 1 by 101. So approximately I am taking 0.01. So it is 10 by 101, which is equals to minus 0.1. So finally take infinity. So it will be 0. 1 by 1 plus infinity square 0. If you take omega square common, so still you have one omega term in denominator. So 1 by infinity will be 0. So now let's draw the Nyquist plot. So remember that always Nyquist plot is symmetric, cyclic, and it's always a closed path. So this is imaginary and this is real. When omega equal to 0, real part is 1. That means suppose at here 1 and imaginary term is 0. So 0. And when omega equal to 1, both are half and half. That means this is half and this is minus half. This is minus half, this is minus half. So let it be somewhere here. And when omega equals to 10, it is real part is 0.01, almost closer to its origin. This is 0.1. So like this, suppose at this point it you have. And at infinity it reaches origin. Both are 0. So if you join them, if you join all these points, so we are starting from omega equal to 0 and this is omega equal to infinity. So in this way we are starting. As it is a symmetric plot, so omega equal to 0 to infinity will be like in this way, and it is minus infinity to 0 will be in this form. As it is a cyclic plot, so in this direction it will be. So this is from omega equal to minus infinity to 0. This is from omega equal to 0 to infinity. And this is the virtual origin minus 1 comma 0. So let's solve using method 2. So g of s into h of s is equals to 1 by 1 plus s. So g of j omega, h of j omega is equals to 1 by 1 plus j omega. So now you want magnitude and phase. So m is equals to 1 by square root of 1 plus omega square. And phase angle is equal to minus tan inverse of omega by 1, which is omega. So now take various values for omega, m and phi. If omega equal to 0, 1 by 1 plus 0, 1. Minus tan inverse of this one 0 degrees. Similarly, omega equals to 1 by 1 plus 1 square root of 1 by root 2. So it will be, suppose, 0.707. Minus tan inverse of 1 minus 45 degrees. 10. So it is 0.1. And minus tan inverse of 10 is minus 84 degrees. Infinity. So it will be 0 and it is minus 90 degrees. Now let's draw. Zero degrees, minus 90, minus 180, minus 270. Now you have to draw the magnitude with phase. So when omega equal to 0, you are having magnitude 1 with phase 0 degrees. That means it will be in this way. When omega equal to 0, this one. When omega equal to 1, so magnitude is 0.707 at an angle minus 45 degrees. That means minus 45 exactly between 0 and minus 90. So it will be minus 45 degrees line this is. So 0.707 somewhere here. Again at 10 it is 0.1 and minus 84 degrees. So minus 84 degrees will be close to minus 90 degrees. So this is minus 84 degree. So magnitude is 0.1, almost near to origin. And finally, it is magnitude 0 and minus 90 degrees. So, join all these points. So, we will get the same thing. And this is inverse. So, this is from omega equal to 0 to infinity. This is from minus infinity to 0. So, in both the ways, you will get the same plot. Now let's see the characteristics of Nyquist plot. The first and important one is Nyquist plot is a symmetric and cyclic plot. Nyquist plot is a symmetric and cyclic plot. The second point, if a system has n poles at origin, then Nyquist plot will start asymptotically parallel to the phase angle minus n pi by 2. Same like in polar plot. If a system has n poles at origin, then the Nyquist plot, then the Nyquist plot will start asymptotically parallel to the phase angle minus n pi by 2 or minus 90 n degrees. The third point is, if a system has n poles and m zeros, then it will start asymptotically parallel to the phase angle minus n minus m pi by 2. If a system has n poles and m zeros at origin, then the Nyquist plot generally, if system has n poles and m zeros, then the Nyquist plot approaches origin at an angle minus n minus m pi. That means this is the closing angle, or minus 90 n minus m degrees. Fourth point, the Nyquist plot crosses the imaginary axis when real of g of j omega h of j omega equal 0. The Nyquist plot crosses imaginary axis when real of g of j omega h of j omega is equal to 0. Similarly, the Nyquist plot crosses real axis when imaginary of g of j omega h of j omega is equal to 0. And the last point is, if a system has no open loop zeros, then the Nyquist plot of g of j omega h of j omega will monotonically decreases. If a system has no open loop zeros, then the Nyquist plot, that means as you increase the omega, the magnitude will decrease. The Nyquist plot of g of j omega h of j omega will monotonically decrease as omega increases. So these are the characteristics you have to remember while drawing the Nyquist plot.